In this video, we're going to look at a t-test for a problem that we have been looking at. So a poll by the National Sleep Foundation found that college students average about 7 hours of sleep per night. Researchers are interested in showing that students at their school sleep longer than 7 hours on average, and they would like to demonstrate this with a sample of students. The college conducted a survey where they asked 110 students how much sleep they averaged per night. The students averaged 7.42 hours per night with a standard deviation of 1.75. We want to conduct a t-test with a significance level of 0.5 to decide whether the college should accept or reject the null hypothesis. So recall, the null and alternative hypotheses are: the null hypothesis is that the students average 7 hours per night, or mu naught equals 7. And the alternative is that they average more than 7 hours per night, or mu a is bigger than 7. We are going to assume that we satisfy the conditions of the central limit theorem. And so the standard error is approximated as 1.75, the standard deviation, divided by the sample size of square root, so the square root of 110, equals 0.17. The test statistic, or t-score, is 7.42, the mean of the distribution, minus 7. 7 is our null hypothesis mean, divided by the standard error of 0.17 equals 2.52. Now this is a one-sided t-test where the alternative hypothesis is that the true mean is above 7. So we compute the p-value as 1 minus, again I'm going to use the Excel version, so 1 minus t.dist of the test statistic, 2.52, comma, 110 minus 1, so the degrees of freedom is 1 less than the number of observations, comma true, and that's equal to 0.6643%. This is less than 0.05, so we reject the null hypothesis and accept the alternative that students at the college sleep more than 7 hours a night.